Vinny Del Negro's future in Chicago. Does he have a future?
Might get fired on the plane tonight.
You think so?
I do. It's a toxic situation. Vinny's a friend of mine, great guy. I like the Paxsons, but it's clearly a toxic situation. And if you can't get along, the coach and the GM and president, you got to let it go. Because what's going to happen, Ernie, is whenever they have a losing streak, the vultures in the media are going to start circling. So it's probably best to cut those ties. Because clearly, when they're trying to choke each other, things are not good. And to me, honestly, to me, that's not even a big deal. I was in the NBA for 16 years. Coaches and players get to fight all the time. I've seen GMs and everybody go at it. But what happens is, in that situation, like next year, let's say they get off to a bad start, the media is going to jump on and say, we need to get rid of Vinny. So it's probably best for everybody involved to go ahead and do it right now.
Well, if you're a coach, you're going to handle the fact that people are getting on you. If you can't handle that, you can't be a coach in the NBA. The one thing that always supersedes everything is winning. So you could hate, you could fight, you could argue, you could dislike. You always have to do two things, respect and win. When you don't respect your coach or you don't respect your general manager, you don't win, those two things are the things that separates ties. So if there's no respect factor, obviously, if they've been fighting. So the next part is that then they haven't been winning. So that's why you would say to me that they won't.
Are you going to agree with me?
Somewhat. I just get to agree with you in a different direction.
So Ernie asked me, was he going to get fired or not?
You took the highway. I took Peachtree to get here.
Okay. Did you stop at the Bulldog?
No. Nah.
Here's one thing we do agree on.
They said they waiting on you. Got your drink cold for you.
Here's one thing we do agree on.
All right.
Where's my hat?
It's right in there.
Okay. It's inside.
This is, we got a couple of teams.
Whoa.
That we have to send on vacation.
Oh, start the boat. Hey, and yeah, here's my pole. Chuck, you need a pole too if you need one. I got one for you. I got a pole for you.
Look at that. Oh, isn't that nice?
There you go, young fella.
You are such an idiot.
You little shaver.
There you go, young fella. Get
what do you say we start with the...
That's a hell of a pole.
Wow.
It's a heck of a cast out there.
Nice.
Let me see if my cast
see,
is better than
I told you, I know how to...
No,
man, you're going to tangle up the cord, fool.
What's up with the Miami Heat?
Oh, we're going fishing around there. It's so beautiful
hey,
down
man.
There. Did I get Pat Riley on my boat? No, I couldn't find him. I got a little heavy, though. I got a little heavy over the summer.
Oh, man, I miss Crockett and Tubbs.
Oh, man.
You got Alien Gonzalez in the water.
Is that there. The guy from Dexter?
I'm not really positive.
I got Kanye. I got Oprah. I should have had Common since he came in here early tonight.
He's hey, that was really cool another, to meet Common.
He's
tonight.
Another
what
Chicago
a nice
guy. He should have been on our little boat.
How did Vince Vaughn? He's that, from yeah, Chicago?
I was wondering if that was Vince Vaughn in the middle there.
You didn't know him?
I think I popped my...
I like this, y'all.
I popped my...
You guys are getting dangerous with those bad boys.
Hey, why did I get this...
Okay, I'm not going to say that.
That is such a good...
Why did you get
that? That is such a good look for you.
Say what you were going to say so I can finish the joke out. Why did you get the what?
I don't like this little pole.
Oh, well, it just goes along with the rest of you.